My name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of Cruise Radio, and this is a narrated tour of Carnival Sunshine. Now, Carnival Sunshine was first launched as Carnival Destiny back in 1996, and it was the world's largest cruise ship at over 100,000 tons. In 2012, it was announced that Carnival Destiny would undergo a massive renovation to become Carnival Sunshine, also becoming her own class of ship. So, whereas she was the Destiny class under Carnival Destiny, she now became the Sunshine class under Carnival Sunshine. A couple of facts about the ship. She was launched as Carnival Sunshine in 2013. She is 893 feet long, carries 2,623 guests, of course, with that's double occupancy. So when you put a third and fourth in that cabin, it'll go well north of 3,000 people on the ship. And she weighs 102,853 tons. So when she went through that major dry dock, they added a couple of thousand tons there, along with some decks and a lot of public spaces. So today, Carnival Sunshine is one of the most popular and well-known ships in the Carnival Cruise Line fleet. And that's because she was the first ship to get all the 2.0 features. I'm talking about Fun Ship 2.0, like the Guy Fieri Guy's Burger Joint, the Alchemy Bar, the Red Frog Pub, the Havana Bar, BlueIguana Cantina. All these different spaces were brand new that weren't on Carnival Destiny. So this was the first ship to have all of these features on one ship. There was like 12 of them, I believe, in total. So we'll start the tour with embarkation. You embark on deck 3 on Carnival Sunshine, and you step right into the Sunshine Atrium. You can't miss it. This big Sunshine sphere, right? It like hangs right in the middle of the atrium. The atrium is on decks 3, 4, and 5 on Sunshine. Now, the atrium is just forward of midship. So you have the staterooms on the forward part of deck 3. You have the atrium just behind the staterooms. Then you have the main dining room. And then behind that, you have the aft main dining room. So on deck 3, you have staterooms, the atrium, a dining room, and then the aft dining room. And between the two dining rooms, there's a kitchen there. There's a no walk-through area. You have to go up to deck 4 if you want to get from, if you want to transit from midship to the aft on deck 3. That'll bring us up to deck 4. Now, when we talk about all these decks here, we're going to go from forward to aft just to make it things easier. So from front to back, if you will. So the very forward part of deck 4 is the liquid lounge. That's the theater. It's two levels. So on the other ships like Carnival, the Conquest class, like Carnival Liberty, Carnival Valor, Carnival Triumph, there's three decks there. So you can enter on decks 3, 4, and 5. Deck 3 on this ship is just staterooms. So you only can enter the liquid lounge on deck 4 or 5 on Carnival Sunshine. As you make your way towards the back of this ship, you'll go through the photo gallery. And the photo gallery is both on the left and right side, or port and starboard side of the ship. And they do open up the cases so you can check out your photos. And don't be afraid to take photos. Like, they don't charge you for taking photos. So you could take literally 1,000 photos and see 1,000 prints of yourself. Probably not the most greenest thing to do, but you can do that if you want to, or check it on your app. This way you could kind of see what photos you want. There's also photo packages there if you want to buy a photo package or what have you. Going back from here, you'll go past the library bar. The library bar has those wine vending machines. I believe they're called aromatic vending machines for the wine, like 3 or 4 different bottles of wine in there to choose from. You have the library as well. Piano bar is located on this deck, piano bar 88. You also have Bonsai Sushi on here and Fahrenheit 555 Steakhouse. At the time of recording this, Fahrenheit 555 is $38 per person. They jacked that price up in November of 2018 from $35 up to $38, but still worth it, still a great value, and still cheaper than if you were to go to a steakhouse on land. Once you round the corner, you have another elevator bank here, which is the midship elevator. Up one level from us is going to be the casino. And then you walk into the Limelight Theater, the Limelight Lounge. That is where the Punchliner Comedy Club is. So you have the comedians doing the PG shows and the rated R shows back here. One thing about this area, it does fill up pretty fast, and it doesn't have the best seating. There is some, you know, decent little booths in here and things like that. But also, if you look, if you're looking at the stage, you look on the left-hand side, you see how this theater kind of wraps around a little bit. That is kind of annoying if you want to watch a comedy show and you're stuck back there because you're having to watch it on a screen, which is better than no screen. But get there early if you want to go get a decent seat at the Punchliner Comedy Club in the Limelight. And just behind the Limelight Lounge, you have a two-story dining room, which is going to be on deck 3 and deck 4. So again, you have two main dining rooms on this ship, the two back here on deck 3 and 4. And then you have one midship, which is called the sunset dining room. And the back or aft dining room is called the sunrise dining room. Typically, one of the dining rooms or one of the levels is just for traditional dining. And then the other one is going to be for your time dining or anytime dining. That depends on the sailing and how many people are going to be on there. I've sailed the ship quite a few times, and it's always been a mixed bag on to where the your time dining people were sitting and the traditional people were. And one thing to note, if you have your time dining, the anytime dining on Carnival Sunshine, you have to check in on deck 5, and then they'll print you out a voucher, and then you take it to the hostess stand. Or if they're too busy, then they give you a pager, and the pager works anywhere around the ship, and they'll buzz you when your table's ready. Now we're going to go up to deck 5 forward, which is going to be the liquid lounge. The liquid lounge is 2 stories, as we said. If you want to get a decent seat, again, get there early. There are some obstructions here. Also, a bar located on deck 3 in the liquid lounge, right against the wall. When you first walk in, look to your left or right. There's a big bar between the two doors, so you can get yourself a drink there or order one from the servers. There's plenty of servers trying to pitch you drinks all throughout the evening in there as well. As we're walking back on deck 5, we're going to pass an ATM machine and then briefly go past the Sunshine Atrium. Again, you can see it's 3 levels there. Level 3, where you embark. Level 4, where the picture gallery is. And then level 5, where the fun shops are located. That's where you're going to find your diamonds and your watches. And if you want to pick up a model ship. Also, the Skybox Sports Bar is located on this deck. That is kind of like slash a casino bar attached to the casino. So if smoking's an issue for you, or if you're sensitive to smoke, you might want to stay out of that, out of the Skybox Sports Bar. The cruise line subscribes to the NFL package on the NFL network. So if it has one of the games, you'll be able to watch all the games in the sports bar there. They no longer air the games around the ship. So if you want to catch an NFL game, you have to go to the sports bar to check it out. Coming out of the sports bar, you'll have the Sunshine Casino. The casino is full of slot machines and full of table games where you can really lose some money or win a lot of money. The cherry on top shop, that's, of course, the candy shop that has the, tons of candy in there. Also, some things for flowers if you want to buy those for formal night or what have you. An arcade also located on deck 4. And then we'll walk through the casino. You'll find all the slot machines here, Wheel of Fortune, and all these things paying some big money. But not really. Maybe they do. I don't know. I've never won really that big. Actually, I won $682 once on a Wheel of Fortune machine on a $5 spin. That was like my biggest ever win, though, in the Carnival Casino. There's also a bar located inside the casino. The casino is a little bit smoky on this ship, so take note to that. A lot of the smokers come and sit around this bar and watch TV as well, especially around the bar. A lot of smoke action around here. The casinos, they try to regulate where some machines are non-smoking and some machines are smoking. I think that's totally stupid, because if you're a smoker and sitting next to a non-smoking machine, like someone's smoking right next to you, so is it really a non-smoking machine? No, it's not at all. But whatever works, I guess, right? Coming out of the casino, you'll come up on the Java Blue Cafe in the shake spot. Of course, you can get your spiked milkshakes or your virgin milkshakes, chocolate, vanilla, strawberry, or mix them up a little bit there if you want to. Also, Java Blue Cafe has your coffees and espressos, your mochas and all that good stuff, and those big slices of the cheesecake. I saw someone walking around with one of these slices of cheesecake the other day. And that thing was massive. It was like the size of a football, bigger than the cheesecake they serve in the steakhouse, which is pretty a big slice of cheesecake. Heading back from here, you're going to come up to the Ocean Plaza area, and that's where you're going to find the Red Frog Pub off to the side. Ocean Plaza has a nice stage where there's trivia held in here. You also have some bands in the evening held in here. And also, there's a buffet area in here, so if you want to grab breakfast or lunch, you can come here to the buffet. A little secret, breakfast time, they do serve hot breakfast down here, and it's nowhere near as crowded as it is up on Lido deck, because Lido can be a zoo on this ship. Just the configuration of it is a hot mess, but we'll get to that in just a couple of moments. The Alchemy Bar is back here as well. Used to be back in the day before the refit, that's where the piano bar was and the aft lounge, but now it's all staterooms, part of the 100 and something staterooms they added during the refit on this ship when it went into dry dock in 2013. We'll take a couple of more shots of the Red Frog Pub here. Of course, a lot of games, a lot of seating area here as well. You can't go on the outside of this pub. Like on some ships, there's an outside patio at the Red Frog Pub, not on this one. you're pretty much just kind of stuck inside on the Red Frog Pub here. Deck 6, 7, and 8 is nothing but staterooms, so really no activity happening here. Pretty much from bow to stern is nothing but staterooms. Going up to deck number 9, though, that's where some of the food action is. You have Guy's Burger Joint up there. You also have the BlueIguana Cantina. Both of those are complimentary. Going inside, you have the Lido Deck Marketplace. Now, the Lido Deck Marketplace, a little bit different on this ship than the other ships in its class, because the Lido Deck Marketplace on Carnival Sunshine is just one area, whereas the marketplace on the other cruise ships in the fleet are kind of mirrored areas. So you have one set up in the front, and you have one set up in the back, like buffets. But on this ship, everything's kind of just in one side. A good thing on this ship, though, there is the Havana Bar. And in the Havana Bar, it has the Cucina del Capitano, which is the Italian restaurant. And it has the Gigi Asian Kitchen, which is the Mongolian wok and Asian fusion. At dinner time, both Gigi's and Cucina cost a $15 fee. But during the day, they're both free. So you have the Captain's Pasta Bar at Cucina during the day. And then you have the Mongolian wok at Gigi's Asian Kitchen during the day. Of course, lots of good food in the buffet area and awesome desserts, and gotta love the cake pops. Like, just get so many of those. Also on the back of Carnival Sunshine is the Havana Bar, where Gigi's and Cucina is, they're both located inside of there. Also the Havana Bar as well. But there's extra seating in there in this area. So if you want to, like if you grab something from the buffet, or you know, grab a burger or a taco by the pool and you can't find a seat, walk back here to the back of Deck 9. And typically you can grab a table, whether it be off in one of the little restaurants or at the very back, kind of tucked away in a corner. A lot of nooks and crannies on this ship. I should also mention that the pizza place, Pizzeria del Capitano, and the different pizzas you can have made to order, that's located within the Lido Deck Marketplace area. So you won't find that outside on Carnival Sunshine. It's inside in the Lido Deck Marketplace. Stepping outside now to the Serenity area, which is going to be on Deck 11, Deck 12, and Deck 14. Now, whenever the ship was first launched and the renderings came out, everyone was really stoked about the Serenity area because, one, it's three levels. Two, a big freshwater pool in the Serenity, adults only. You know, some of the pools, like on Carnival Liberty in the back, they say it's adults only, but kids are doing cannonballs in there, and it's loosely enforced. This one, kids are not going into this pool here. And you have that two-story waterfall falling into the pool, which people are really stoked about that as well. And it's just a cool vibe. Like, you're in the middle of the Caribbean, you're laying next to a waterfall in the middle of the ocean. It's one of those wish-you-were-here kind of things, right? The location of Serenity is ideal on this ship, probably the best yet, even better than the new ships Carnival has, because you have, I mean, it's pretty much open air right dab smack in the middle of the ship, where as the other ships, it's forward and, you know, they have those big glass panes that come over it, which they still do on this ship all the way forward. It kind of restricts the airflow, I guess is what I'm trying to say, where as this being right in the middle, you're just wide open. You know, on the older Carnival ships, they have the Serenity area located in the very back, and they kind of pigeonhole you back there, where there's not a lot of fresh air and a lot of stagnant air back there, whereas this one just loads of fresh air in the Serenity area. Also on deck, down on the pool deck, you have the big beach pool there. You have the Red Frog Rum Bar, the BlueIguana Tequila Bar. Of course, that's where you have the guys in the BlueIguana Cantina with the free tacos and the free burritos there. And you'll notice this, like other ships, later ships with Carnival, you have the tiered system. So you have the deck on Deck 9, which is the Lido deck, and it gradually goes up. So like an amphitheater seating or like risers, there's different levels going up to Deck 10 and then 11. And then, you know, you walk up the steps to Deck 12 there. You'll also find two hot tubs located on Deck 9 midship by the beach pool. So I'm going to quit talking for a couple of minutes here and give you a little bit more of a tour of Serenity. Then we'll hop back and go to the back of the ship and check out the water park.
Thank you.
Unlike other ships in the Carnival fleet that have the water park midship, aside from the fantasy class ship, when they underwent the evolutions of fun, like in 2010, they started putting those water slides in the back of the ship. But like the newer class ships, the Conquest class, and moving forward, a lot of the water parks are midship. This one is in the back of the ship, and that's probably because they have that big ocean pool midship. There's three slides back here. There's a racing slide, so this is pretty cool. So you can go on to the green slide or the blue slide, and they're pretty much exactly the same. They just go on different sides of the ship, and you meet down in the middle, and it's timed. So you can see like who actually got down the slide quicker. And then you have your typical, and Carnival has on most of all of their ships, the yellow twister slide. This area of the ship on sea days is kind of a hot mess, because especially if there's a lot of kids on the sailing, because all the kids like to gravitate back here. But I guess it's by design, right? Because Serenity's in the middle of the ship where the adults are and the kids are in the back of the ship. And it kind of divides everyone up. So yeah, the water park here is nice. A lot of loungers out here. No bars or anything back here at the water park. If you move forward a little bit, you can you'll find a bar there. But other than that, just a lot of fun in the sun back here. As you're transitioning or walking from the water park, the WaterWorks area, to the midship where the beach pool is and all that, you're going to come through the playground here, and that is the Camp Carnival Playground, or some ships call it Camp Ocean. I guess it depends on which ship you're on. Although I thought they rolled out Camp Ocean like 4 years ago on all the ships, but maybe not. But anyway, there's a kid area here, which is convenient because the slides are right aft of this area. And if you were to keep walking forward, you go to the Serenity area or go down one level to the beach pool and grab yourself a guy's burger. Opposite of where we're standing right now is going to be where you can get into the Camp Carnival area, Camp Ocean, that has like the Circle C and all those programs for the kids back there. So the opposite side, so I guess we're standing on the port side, so the starboard side, you would have the entrance for the kids area. There's also an elevator there. And then if you were to walk back from this area, so go aft once you walk out the door, that would put you back into the water park again. Deck 12 is going to be where the golf course is, the mini golf. And the golf course actually, I guess you could say it circumnavigates the funnel, the big whale tail, the big red smokestack on the ship. So just forward of this golf area is going to be where the Lido deck is, where the dive-in movie screen is, where you can watch movies. And then all around here is the miniature golf, and you have a little baby whale tail on the golf course as well, which is actually part of one of the holes here. It's a pretty fun area. I mean, the first time I golfed in my adult life was actually on this ship in 2013. Otherwise, I was like 10 years old at like Goonie Golf or Putt-Putt Golf here in Jacksonville. Walking down to the deck 11 right now, which is the sports square. Here you have the ropes course. You have a basketball court, like a giant life-size twister game. Just a little place to chill out here. You have a little bar here, some TVs and all of that. So if you foosball, you name it, they have it. Also an elevator that goes up to the sky course as well, which is the ropes course right above us. If you're a runner or you like that brisk morning walk outside or evening walk when the sun's setting, you could actually do it on the jogging track here. However, it's not that big. So if you want to bang out 3 or 5 miles in the morning, like I always go up to the gym. That seems to be the best place to go. And to be honest, not a lot of people are at the gym first thing in the morning. I mean, they're at the buffet eating. They need to be at the gym, but they're enjoying some food, but hey, you do you, right? I'm not judging anyone. But the gym on board is really nice, though, if you ever want to go up there and just check it out. Even if you don't want to work out, they probably have 2 or 3 dozen different treadmills up here. Some freelance weights. You have the typical machines, the bicycles, the mats, so we can do some stretches. And they have the scale up here, which I tend to stay away from because I already know. I go into a cruise knowing I'm going to gain weight. And there's no sense of reinforcing how much weight I've gained on this cruise. So Carnival also has the spa accommodations, which include like the private access to the spa, special amenities, and priority reservations at the Cloud 9 Spa. And that's located on like decks 11, 12, 10, I believe. And I think there's some staterooms, some spa staterooms on deck 9. I know there's a couple of levels of staterooms here on Carnival Sunshine that have the spa in there. And I'll tell you what, I first did my first spa treatments on Carnival Breeze earlier this fall, and I don't think I'll ever sail on a ship again without a spa and not get the spa pass, because the spa pass is the way to go. It's like $129 a week or $169. Total access and just well worth it. You also have the thermal suites, Cloud 9 Spa, the fitness studio, and a little secret, not a secret, more like a tip, but if you are traveling with a large group of people, or heck, even if you're traveling with just one other person and you want to have your own shower, man or woman, just go right up to the Cloud Nine Spa and use their shower area, because you can just take your shower and then go back to your room and get ready, or get ready there. It really doesn't matter. The showers are a lot bigger. I did that a lot on Carnival Breeze, where I went up to the spa and used the men's locker room to take a shower, because you just have a big open space there and not having to worry about taking too long in there or someone else being in there or what have you. So yeah, feel free to use the spa up there. I mean, if no one's using it, hop in and it'll maybe alleviate some of that getting ready stress. That will about do it for our tour of Carnival Sunshine. Thank you so much for watching this. By the way, if you have any questions about this ship, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I'll be happy to answer them for you and get back with you as soon as I see them. Also, after I'm done speaking, there will be another few more minutes of video here, and that's because I have a lot of B-roll, as we call it. We're just kind of walking around the ship with my camera, taking some photos. If you want to see some more public spaces, hang on here just a little bit longer and you'll see some more video. Once again, my name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of the Cruise Radio podcast and the Cruise Radio news briefs. You can find both of those however you listen to your favorite podcast. Just type in Cruise Radio or Cruise Radio news, and you can subscribe and hear our daily news briefs or our show every Thursday. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. I've been on this, I have 67 days on this ship, so I've been on here for quite a few sailings, and I really do like this ship. It's one of my favorites. She has some charm to her. So leave those questions in the comments below, and I'll get back with you as soon as possible. Until next time, thank you so much for watching, and hang through for a few more minutes of Carnival Sunshine video.